Hey, what's up guys? Thanks for tuning in. So today we're going to talk about a brand new camera that I got. Yes! Is it an X-Pro 3? Spoiler alert, nope! So it's well documented about my Fujifilm kind of fiasco with the X-H1. You can see the video here. Nailed it. I pretty much had the money for an X-Pro 3 and I decided not to buy one or wait until it came out and then purchase it. But instead I got this, the Leica M6. So why should I go to an X-Pro 3 when I can just go to the real thing, you know? And I'm so glad I did it. Like, oh, this thing is a beast and I love it. It's taught me so much more about photography than getting a Fujifilm X-Pro 3. I think it's just elevated my game so much more. So that was one instance where Fujifilm failed to take my money. And here is instant number two why Fujifilm was not able to take my money. And oh, by the way, this isn't like a Fujifilm bashing or anything. I don't want to put that negativity out there. This is actually coming from a former Fujifilm fanboy. It's kind of embarrassing, but at one time I had 5 Fujifilm cameras. Like, I had the X100F, X-T20, X-Pro 2, X-T2, and X-70. Yeah, pretty bad. But anyways, I'm glad I smartened up. I'm down to 2 digital cameras. I had 3. I sold one off. I sold the X70. I actually got a replacement here for it. But now I have the Fujifilm X-H1 and the X-T2 as my professional backup. So again, this isn't a Fujifilm bashing. I'm just glad I kind of smartened up and started investing in my photography and just getting a camera that I can hold on to forever. All right, so without further ado, what camera is it? Bam! Contax G2. Oh my gosh, it's just so pretty. By the way, the autofocus on this is actually really fast. It's a lot faster than I thought it would be. You hear of these reviews and, oh, the autofocus isn't too fast, it's this, it's that, it's, you know, doesn't compare to digital, but obviously, because it's not a digital camera, it doesn't have 2020 technology in it. But it actually is really fast. Like, think of it as like a X-Pro 1, X-Pro 2, in between there, like that kind of speed. I'm not even joking. Oh, I'm so happy I got this. So the question is, why did I get this? First of all, I don't have to justify myself because I'm a grown-ass man. Second of all, I'm going to justify myself because I'm a grown-ass man and I'm going to tell you whether I want to justify myself or not justify myself. So I'm going to justify myself. Thirdly, Justified album by Justin Timberlake is a very underrated album and I still listen to it to this day. All right, so anyways, so why I got this was, there's a number of reasons, a lot of reasons, is I actually do 2 different type of genres of photography. I do street photography and I do fashion photography. Personal work is street photography. I have a channel on street photography. That's just my personal passion. I don't plan on making any money for it. That's why I try to give you guys as much feedback and information as much as I can, because I want to actually add and give back to the genre. But in terms of my professional work and in terms of where I want to go in terms of my career, which is fashion and lifestyle stuff, this M6 is not cutting it. I did a photo shoot with this and it was a struggle. Like trying to manual focus something, a model that's moving because my particular style of photography, I like movement, I like nuances, so I like, you know, I like the model doing something. And to capture that with manual focus is like, what the hell? And then a lot of my shots, I would say 60 to 70% of the shots are in portrait mode. So again, trying to capture and shoot like this, looking through the rangefinder, and it's just, it's a headache. And with zone focusing, it's like, I tried to think about zone focusing my model, and I was like, this is retarded. Like, this is not how I shoot, like, at all. Again, I would say in my street photography, I would say 95% of the time, I'm shooting at F8. At F8 or F11 or F16. I rarely go to 5.6 according to the light. Maybe I'm in a subway or something like that, 2.8. But I would say 90 to 95% of the time, I'm shooting street photography at F8. Now, when I shoot fashion and lifestyle stuff, 90% of the time, I'm shooting at F2 to F2.8. And that is a very big difference in depth of field and just shooting styles. And also, I need autofocus. Like, it's a must, because again, what I learned, when you're shooting for money, when you're shooting for clients, and you can't be f***ing around with, you know, not getting shots in focus. When it comes to money, like, you can't fuck around with that stuff. So your shots need to be in focus. And this autofocus, like, oh my gosh. It's a godsend. So that's a huge, huge reason why I ended up getting the Contax G2, was just that simple thing. I wanted to shoot film as closely as possible with the feeling that I shoot with digital. And there's a certain flow, there's a certain, you know, rhythm I get when I'm shooting lifestyle and fashion stuff. Because I'm concentrating on the model, I'm concentrating on composition, I'm directing, I'm giving them words, there's music going, there's just so much going on. And the last thing I need to do is, hold on, let me focus, let me, hold on. It's just, there's just no way. And so this was a really big reason. And also, I love the look of flash. Having that kind of lo-fi look with the on-camera flash, I love that look. So this flash is specifically built for the Contax G2. There's actually settings on top here where you can adjust to see what focal length you are. I love that idea. And I've always been a fan of Terry Richardson, Jürgen Teller, those type of photographers who use it onboard flash. And yeah, man, so to have that kind of flexibility, whether I want to use natural light or kind of a cool lo-fi party atmosphere type of photo, I can do that. Also, lastly, and one of the most important, is the Contax G2 Zeiss lens. Like, this 45mm f2, so far I've shot, I think, two rolls with it, and it's, oh my gosh. Some say this is, as far, I've read a bunch of reviews, and again, I haven't done an extensive amount of rolls with it, but what I've seen thus far, like, oh, these images are amazing already. Some say, I've read some reviews, some say this lens, for 35mm, might be the best lens ever made. So a notch above Leica glass, like the Summicrons, all that. And when I see the images, I'm like, ooh, like, that's actually really nice. Like, the color rendering, the sharpness, it's so good. So I'm just super excited that I got this. Again, I shoot a multiple different genres of photography. You can check out my work at j.rose on Instagram. That's my professional and personal account. And then obviously my at j.photos is this street photography stuff. So again, man, I'm just so happy that I made this decision, A, going into film, and then B, trying to switch my professional work into film as well. And I need specific tools for specific mediums or genres. And that's just kind of fact. I've been shooting fashion stuff for a few years now, and there's a certain feeling, there's a certain workflow. And this, doing it with the Leica, it was way too choppy. But mind you, when I'm actually shooting street photography with this, like, I love it. I love the labor. I love the just manual focusing. I love all that. But how many times am I really shooting out one scene? Maybe two photos. Maybe if it's a really good scene, I'm shooting three shots on film. But with fashion, I can shoot one whole look with one roll. So that's a huge, huge difference in shooting styles. And shooting at f2, 2.8, something like that, like, oh my gosh. So yep, this is the camera, and yeah, and also I got another camera. So again, this is pretty much the equivalent of buying a Fujifilm X-Pro3 or buying another Leica M6 body only. And again, oh yeah, speaking of, the fact that this wonderful, great, fucking amazing lens is the standardized lens to this camera, and I can get this lens, this flash, and this body for 3/4 of the price of just the Leica M6 body, like, bro, like, hell yeah, I'm gonna do it. And then with that other quarter of the money, I went and bought this Contax T2. And I love this already. I love having really good image quality. Again, I shot maybe two rolls of this already. And I just love the fact that this can now go with me wherever I want. It's so compact, it's so little. And again, my hands are decent size, relatively big, whatever. So it's still kind of hefty. And again, I like the idea of having Carl Zeiss lens in this small body, and I can take this anywhere. So more of my casual shooting, I just shoot with this. Shots of my wife. Just the other week, we had a whole like street photography walk with Samuel, Bello, my homie Vichette, Leo. And after we got done wrapping the video, I took this out and I was taking more shots of us and just hanging out and cool casual stuff. Actually, that roll is still in this camera. But yeah, so this is the rest of the money, the 1/4 of the money of this. I bought a walk-around daily camera. So I got rid of my Fujifilm X70, my beloved, beloved camera that I actually featured on this channel. I took it to the Philippines. All those shots that are right here in this video, nailed it. I took with the Fujifilm X70. To be honest, I might buy that camera back maybe sometime down the road. Because I used to let my wife kind of use it when we're out traveling, but I had to sell it so I can afford these. So yes, these are my two cameras, two more tools into my photography. I'm super excited. I can't wait to just put more and more rolls. I have an exciting trip actually at the end of the week, so stay tuned. Follow me on IG for my shenanigans. But yeah, and that's it, guys. I just wanna fill you guys in on what I'm doing, what tools I'm using now, just to kind of further my photographic journey. Again, this is all personal stuff that's kind of catered and geared towards me. And yeah, I'm not kind of like ashamed of buying multiple cameras. It's a whole other conversation in its own. This whole negative connotation of gas, like gear accusation syndrome. Accusation? Acquisition. God damn it. I'm accusing you of getting all the... acquisition syndrome. Yeah, I have a quote that I like to say with people who claim that you have too much gas or you're just fine. It's like, it's not that big of a deal, man. It's not that serious. Like, there are other worse things in the world than cameras. Like, the minute... I've always said this quote. The minute you see me starting to suck for cameras, like, okay, I have a problem. I have a problem. So anyways, I just want to thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned. I should be having another video coming out soon as well, hopefully. Yeah. As always, just be cool. Be nice. Be sexy. Be positive. And oh, by the way, with the passing of Kobe Bryant last night, who's my guy, if you know me personally, like, that one hurt. So here it goes. Lakers, baby. Kobe for life. Context G2. I'm mixing the names of my babies up. Like, hey, Sarah, Jenny, whatever your name is, come over.